and welcome to today's Moment with Mike. I hope that you're having a great day and a good week so far. You know, this week we're talking about why bad things happen to good people. Paul was a changed character. He had been radically changed from the inside out, and he was going around doing some great work, helping people to change their lives for good. One day he was out with a mate called Silas, and they got into some serious trouble with the city officials. In fact, they were completely misunderstood, and they were put into prison. In fact, it says that they were put into a maximum security cell, and their legs were put in leg irons. So in other words, they were bolted to the floor so they couldn't escape. This was a pretty serious situation. It says about midnight that Paul and Silas were singing songs and praying to God. I mean, come on, I don't know whether we'd be that strong in that situation. But then they encountered something else. There was an earthquake. I mean, come on, get real. Firstly, these guys are beaten black and blue for doing good. Then they're put in a maximum security cell. Their feet are bolted to the ground so they can't escape. And now an earthquake? All for going around and doing good? You know, the amazing thing is that it was in this next kind of scenario that they really began to see God working together for good. Because what happened in the shake of that quake was all the cell doors were opened, but not one prisoner escaped. In fact, the prison officer was ready to take his own life because he realized the seriousness of the situation. And Paul shouted out and said, "Don't do that." And this guy said, "Well, how can I give my life to God? How can I be saved?" And Paul was able to lead him and his entire family into a personal relationship with God. It's amazing what God will allow to happen through us in order for one person or one family to get saved, for one life or one family to turn around. That's God working all things together for good. Have a great day.